your host, SCU VP for Student Development, Dr. Bethany Thomas, and you are watching SCU Now, our weekly update show where we keep you informed and educated on everything happening right now at SCU. And we have a very special episode planned for today as we will be talking about financial aid awareness. In addition to Black History Month, the Higher Education Committee also recognizes February as Financial Aid Awareness Month. The National Association of Student Financial Aid Administrators emphasizes the importance of spreading awareness in order to provide crucial information to both students and their families about access to federal, state, and institutional student aid. Here with us to discuss this topic is our Executive Director of Student Financial Services, Mike Yohe. Hello.
Hello. Thank you.
Of course. We love having you here. And SCU student Felipe Ledesma.
Good morning. Buenos dias.
Buenos dias. Mike and Felipe, welcome to the show. Thank you for taking the time to join me. I look forward to our conversations. I can't wait. Both in English and Spanish. Feel free to, you know, interject.
I might throw a little Spanish.
I would love that.
A little bit of Russian.
See what I can do. Maybe.
Okay.
You never know.
That would be amazing. And before we get started, as usual, we want to fill you in on the top three things you need to know this week. We're a busy place. I don't know if you guys know
this. There's a lot going on.
It's a lot. Finding top three is hard because there's top 20. But first is the School of Music will be hosting the Spring Orchestra Concert tonight, February 22nd at 7:30 p.m. in Bush Chapel, which is super exciting. The SCU Symphony Orchestra will present Tales of Distant Lands, featuring works from American and French composers. Everyone is welcome to attend. It's free. Do you have any friends in it, Felipe?
The band?
Yeah.
No.
Oh. I don't have. Okay, it's amazing.
So talented.
I know.
I will have to find a friend in the band.
Okay, Keon Williams.
Oh, I know Keon,
okay,
actually.
Okay, he will be, Williamson, right?
Yes.
Yes, he will be in it, and he actually learned an extra instrument. He was on the show last week. Shout out, Keon. He usually plays the tuba, but they needed a bass trombonist, so he learned that in 3 weeks.
Wow.
And is playing in the orchestra tonight, so make sure you check it out February 22nd. Tonight, 7:30 p.m. Bush Chapel. Tomorrow, on February 23rd, the Steelman Library will be hosting a Dessert and Learn event in honor of Black History Month at 1 p.m. in the library's C Lab. The session will feature Kim Smiley, who serves as the director for the Center of Well-Being in Winter Haven, and she'll be discussing mental health and self-care. Everyone is welcome to join. That's tomorrow in the library at 1 p.m. So make sure you're there. Get some dessert. Also tomorrow, the Department of Multicultural Affairs will be holding a Soulful Family Feud event at 7:30 p.m. Sounds amazing. Soulful Family Feud event in Buena Vista West Auditorium. That's at 7:30, and everyone is invited to come for this fun trivia event highlighting Black culture. So I heard there's going to be a special host.
Who is?
Not Steve Harvey. I asked.
It's a secret, or
it is a secret.
Is it
okay,
you?
Do you know?
No, no clue.
I don't either. I thought you were going to tell me. I have no idea. They wouldn't
so
even
we
tell
have
me.
A secret and food and soulful music.
Yeah,
and it's a game.
Sounds like
everybody loves
and a game.
Family Feud.
I know. I'm down. 7:30 p.m. tomorrow night. Buena Vista West, be there. Now, let's get this started. Mike, let's talk about the importance of financial aid awareness. How have you seen the use of various sources of aid impact our students' journey?
Absolutely. And thanks again for having me
of
on
course.
Today. So for most of our students, that process starts with the free application for federal student aid, or known as the FAFSA.
Okay.
So we love our acronyms in financial aid,
yes.
So we throw those around like everybody knows what we're talking about. But
yeah.
That's a great first step for students, but the most important one in most cases. Not everyone would qualify. If you're an international student, you may not be eligible to file.
Yeah.
But there are so many other resources available to you, and for most students, it's a combination of putting all those pieces together to get that successful journey forward.
Yeah.
So it's federal aid, state aid, institutional aid, outside scholarships, work study, all of it together.
Yeah.
Felipe can probably tell you a little more about that today, but it's going to take a little of everything. It takes the whole package to get there.
Yeah. And SCU does such a great job at showing students exactly what they have available to them.
Yes.
You know, and I feel like the resources are limited if you like take the time to like actually like invest into learning about it and applying for the things that you need to apply for. But Felipe, tell us a little bit about your story. Where are you from and what brought you here to SCU?
Well, it's a long story, but I'm going to make it short.
I'm
Juan Felipe Ledesma Arce. We were talking about long names.
Yeah.
So you can call me Felipe.
Okay.
I'm from Colombia, South America.
Yeah.
I am part of Southeastern, second year, sophomore year, but by credits I am junior, senior.
Sure.
And I'm political science major, theology major, and business in minor in business.
Oh, great.
I'm part of student government, part of track and field, cross country. Hi to my friends, my teammates. And I enjoy being around political things, helping people, serving others. So I enjoyed all the things. Why drive me here to Southeastern? A miracle. And part was a financial miracle.
Yeah, so, tell us about that. How has financial aid played a part of your story?
Yes, it's a key thing in my story. It's like a foundational thing. Like, if you want to go to school, you need to plan. You need to think, how am I going to pay school? Or how is going to that be paid?
Yeah.
So just to give an example, imagine that this watch that I have here in America has the value of $1, right? Yeah. So I would have to work 1 hour, just imagine, and I can pay it. But back in Colombia, 2 years ago, the currency was like, I have to work three times to get the same item for the same value.
Yeah.
So that was like the first wall that I was like seeing in front of me.
Yeah.
And financial help me to first plan what I want to get. Like, I want to arrive to Southeastern. That's my dream school. And then I have the support from people of the community. And also, I think you mentioned FAFSA. I cannot apply to FAFSA, but all of you guys, many of you can apply.
Yeah.
And that was a push. Like, I can do it. I can come here and God is going to do a miracle. And well, I'm here, and that's the proof that he's still working and he used all those resources.
Yeah. Was it easy to work with financial aid about that?
Yes. I think it was easy. Even I was in other country.
Yeah.
So imagine that. I'm miles apart from here.
You literally have to do it by the phone.
Yes. Yeah. That was my first call, like first contact.
Yeah.
I want to say their name, Miss Eileen Colon.
Yes. She called me.
She's the best. And I was honest with her. So, ma'am, I don't have the money to pay school.
Yeah.
I have this amount of money.
Yeah.
She's like, that will be hard. But we will see what we can do. Because you're honest and I can see that you really are going to work in things, I'm going to do my research.
Yeah.
And they were so helpful. Like,
that's amazing.
Helpful research.
That's amazing. Thank you for sharing that story. Mike, for any prospective students listening out there who may be considering applying to SEO, what are some key institutional and federal resources they should be aware of?
Absolutely. So when you apply to Southeastern, you are guaranteed an academic scholarship right off the bat. So
no matter
what your GPA, test scores, no matter what that looks like, you're getting something. So,
that's cool.
Yeah. So, of course, a lot of students and families, they might be looking at different options. You might see the cost and be intimidated by that. I would just say, as Felipe stated, it may look intimidating up front, but you have no idea all the different pieces that can come together and make it possible. So don't rule it out just looking at the price.
Yeah.
But you file the FAFSA if you can. You're going to get some institutional aid scholarships from us automatically.
That's amazing.
And then from there are lots of additional opportunities that you can seek out in student leadership on campus, applying for additional deadline-driven scholarships. We have some that are a February 15th deadline that we just passed, but it's not too late to apply for endowments that are for next year. So there are all these little things that they can do that sort of stack up and give you a complete picture of what you're looking at. So
I want to go back and talk about endowment scholarships since you mentioned it, but what's really cool is that so anyone can get institutional scholarship.
Yes,
just
absolutely.
Honestly, cool for even people that don't maybe have good GPAs in high school.
Mm-hmm.
Just to even say you got some sort of a scholarship.
Yeah.
Just gives you that like confidence you need to like walk into your college experience.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, I just think that's really cool that SU does that, because speaking from a person who didn't get scholarships, you know, it just would have give me some confidence to know that a school values me enough to give me something to help, you know, along with that aid. So I think that's a really cool feature that SU does. Now share with us, you talked about endowed scholarships.
Yeah.
Share about the university's endowed scholarship, who can apply for those, and what are some of the qualifications?
Yeah. So if anybody doesn't know what that means, our endowments are made possible by generous donors and organizations that want to start scholarship funds for students here at Southeastern University. And I can tell you there are hundreds of students every semester looking for help that are facing hardships. So if you're out there and you want to start an endowment,
absolutely
contact our advancement team.
That's
they would
really cool.
love to help you set that up. But those are made possible by these donors, and students apply for those each year between February 1st and March 1st. So that window is open right now for the upcoming year. So you can apply today. They give you a list of what the different endowments are. When those are set up, the donors may set criteria to them. It might be for a student that's from a certain country, from a certain state in a particular academic program. But you can see the criteria listed out on the website, and you can apply for up to five of those.
Wow.
And then we make those notifications to students later in the spring semester.
That's
so you'll
cool.
know what you have available to you for next year.
And if you are a current student who didn't know about that, can mm-hmm. you go apply now?
You can.
So it can be for future, like yep. their junior year if they didn't yep. get it before. That's
Correct.
Really cool. Now talk to us, is it true that Pell Grants will be increasing next fall? If so, who will that impact?
Yeah, absolutely. So if you do file a FAFSA application mm-hmm. and you qualify for the federal Pell Grant, that's a need-based grant
yeah.
made possible by the government. The amount is going up for next year.
That's
it's
awesome.
Going to be just over $7,000, almost $7,400
wow.
is the maximum amount.
Okay.
So
and that's
students,
annually?
It's annual,
okay.
yep. And they could receive anywhere, you know, in that range if they qualify. So not everyone would get the maximum, but that's the highest it's ever been. So in the history of the Pell Grant program, we're at the highest level at the maximum side of the Pell eligibility. So
wow.
filing the FAFSA will determine if you qualify.
Yeah.
And so it's great to see that the government is funding that at a
that's
higher
amazing.
Level.
Yeah. So there's a lot eligible. I think students just need to know that you have to put in the effort too.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Like as a student, you have to own your individual journey,
mm-hmm.
you know, because a lot of people just think, oh, they're going to just give me everything that I can. But you actually have to apply for it, you know, fill out the
yes.
FAFSA like we need people to fill out and
yes.
even go online and look at all those scholarships and endowments to see what they can apply for.
Yeah. Yep. And I guarantee, you know, Felipe can tell you those didn't just fall in his lap. you know, he has to put lots of different pieces together. He didn't,
yeah.
you know, wasn't even eligible to file a FAFSA and still found a way between institutional scholarships, athletic scholarships,
yeah.
endowments that he's receiving.
Yeah.
I don't want to tell too much of your situation,
yeah.
but, you know, it's a great example of you got to go out and really
yeah.
do the legwork, do some research. Our office is here to help, but, yeah.
Now, Felipe, you talked about earlier, not online, but now that we're online, you can talk about it. You run cross country.
Yes.
And that has helped even supply some of the scholarships you get for going to school.
Yes, being part of the cross-country team in track and field first was hard. Like, you have to run a lot, many miles.
Like 9 or 11 today, you said.
Yes,
that's
incredible. I mean, you get...
You'd have to pay
shape.
Me a lot of money
Not even
to
for
do that.
Competition, it's
yeah.
just you just have to for practice, which is wild.
And so being part of the cross-country team was hard, but I knew, like, if it's God's will and
yeah.
coach see potential in me and
yeah.
I know I can do it, maybe I can have like some help from that area. So
yeah.
running can help me. So it's
yeah.
kind of working.
Yeah.
And has been an amazing thing. Like that scholarship is helping me also to continue studying here. I'm an athlete and a student and it's been great.
That's incredible. So you get to do something that's healthy for your body and get paid to do it to continue to go to school.
Yes.
And you also find time to be involved in student leadership too, right?
Yep.
Oh yes. I've been having the honor of being
yeah.
part of the student government.
Yeah.
Also
mm-hmm.
as an RA,
yep.
a resident assistant.
All sorts of things.
Honor the school.
All of it.
So I have been like around all school.
You're busy. Do you have
he's
time
busy.
For anything else?
I don't know how he's even here right now.
And you're smiling.
Oh yeah. Wait. You have to smile if no.
Yeah.
You can have all the scholarships, but you have to enjoy the process.
Yeah,
yes.
that's
right?
so true. Now, what advice, Felipe, would you give for a prospective student who may feel held back from attending college due to financial concerns?
So first, as a Christian institution, we believe this in divine design, right?
Yeah.
So if you believe that God has a purpose in you,
yeah.
first, believe that.
Yep.
Second, make a plan. Don't just jump into something
yeah.
by faith.
Yep.
Yeah. You need faith, but also you need to plan.
Yep.
Start looking for some ideas, some grants, scholarships that you can apply. And if you are not a student, you want to send one of your child's sons, daughters,
yeah.
in future, start
yeah.
planning for their university. So
mm-hmm.
that can be really helpful. And finally, don't hesitate in asking people. Like, you don't know who is able to help you.
Yeah.
If you stay quiet and you don't share what you're going through, it's going to be hard to help you.
Mm-hmm.
You have to expose yourself, like,
yeah.
share the reality. And there are some people who want to help you.
Yeah.
So that's my advice.
Great advice.
I love that. It's huge. Thank you for sharing all that. It's going to be so helpful to future students and current students. Mike, what advice would you give to students who may not know where to start? I know
yeah.
for me, I didn't even know where to begin when I said this goal.
Right?
Yeah, and like, there's all these sites and all these things you click on. When it comes to their financial aid journey, where can they find more information and where do they begin?
Well, I sound like a broken record, but that FAFSA application
gets you started.
That's a great first step. I would definitely do that. And then after you've got, you know, at least a couple schools maybe on your radar of where you want to go, the admission or enrollment counselors and the financial aid counselors at any of those schools, Southeasterns are particularly good at this, but are there to help. So like Felipe mentioned, you need to reach out and ask for help, and then they're there to walk you through next steps. You're not in it alone. You don't have to wonder what to do next. You know, our office is available, you know, if they want to come up and sit down with a counselor or schedule a phone appointment. Email if that's what it needs to be. If you're not local, it's not a problem. So really staying in touch with the counselor along the way is important.
1,000%.
Letting them know where you need help.
And don't wait till last minute.
Oh, yeah. Deadlines are important.
Yeah. So, like, pretend the deadline's, like, 10 days before the deadline. You know what I mean?
A deadline for the deadline.
I always do that. I always set it as, like, a week earlier. So that way, if I have last-minute questions, they can get answered quicker than everyone else trying to call the day of the deadline.
Yeah.
But that's just a quick little tip that someone can put
it's
in their back
tip.
Pocket. No
think,
one asked, but there.
I think our resource that some people can reach out is a local church.
Yeah.
Sometimes local church have a specific budget for students,
they
a specific
do.
Major,
yep.
and that
yep.
can be helpful
they
if
do.
You really need it.
Yeah, that's a great resource. I know the church I go to can give scholarship to students that go to college. They just have to simply apply and tell them what school they're going to.
Yeah, you know? I mean, Southeastern, like you mentioned, does a lot to help support students, but our funding can't do it all, so looking for those outside resources is really
great.
Important.
Yeah.
A lot of times we'll talk to students who are looking for help, you know, and they might apply for a few of those outside scholarships and they get frustrated because they don't receive one quickly. But if you think about it as like a part-time job, you know, a lot of times in summer students are willing to put in 20, 30, 40 hours a week working at a restaurant or whatever they might. But if you say, okay, I'm going to make applying for these scholarships a part-time job as well, I'm going to put in
five hours
a week,
hours
a week, and I'm going to apply for as many as I can, you'll really start to see the impact that has over time. But don't get discouraged if you just do two or three and you don't get it. There's a lot out there, but it does take time.
I played golf in high school, and the school I chose didn't have a women's golf team, but there was a women's golf scholarship available to me, not connected to the school, because I played in high school. And so, like, it was just, like, I applied for so many different scholarships, even not at the university. Like you were saying, churches have them, the school has them, but there was literally just, like, the LPGA that has women's golf scholarships, and I was able to get that just for playing it in high school.
That's awesome.
You know? And so there's so many things and so many resources. So
love it.
Do a little Google search. You'll find lots of things, but I'll start with the FAFSA. That's the best takeaway I can get. Pray about it and start with the FAFSA.
Yes, definitely.
I love that.
Yeah, have a plan. That's such great. Thank you guys for taking the time to join me today and talking about such a big thing that people don't want to talk about. And it's something that is a huge part of their college process and something that a lot of people think about and worry about. But it's so helpful that we can talk about it and bring awareness to that. So it's been awesome hearing about it. And as usual, if you're listening, keep up with the latest SEU news and updates online and follow us on social media at SEU University and at Bethany T. Thomas. I hope you all have an amazing week. And we look forward to connecting with you again on SEU Now. Have a great day.